After weeks of exceptionally cautious buildup, SpaceX's first orbital-class Starship prototype has repeatedly broken new ground tests, in the first few hours of its first static fire test window. SpaceX first installed Starship S20 on one of two suborbital launch and test stands more than 2 months ago. After almost 6 weeks of largely invisible work, longer than any other new Starship prototype has spent inactive, at Starbase launch facilities, Ship 20 came to life for the first time during a pneumatic proof test completed on September 27. Following a preburner test earlier in the week, the R Vac engine fired up for the first time on a Starship. Then, it fired up again, this time accompanied by a sea-level Raptor ignition, later in the evening. Ship 20 has been the main focus of attention, following the expected ground testing path of ensuring the ship was ready for its big day ahead of the Super Heavy booster. With relatively minor thermal protection system TPS liberation suffered during testing thus far, with proof testing, a cryo cycle with the Raptor vacuum engine preburner test, and Thursday's double static fire event, the data gathered will provide modeling for what can be expected from the conditions and vibrations pre-launch. However, the TPS's performance during flight and re-entry will be a key aspect of the test flight objectives. The most significant milestone of the week's testing on Ship 20 was the first ignition of R Vac at Starbase. Before Thursday night's firing, R Vacs had only ever ignited on the test stands at SpaceX's test facility in McGregor. Raptor vacuum-optimized Raptor engine, known as R Vac, that is designed for propulsion in space. The stainless steel spacecraft prototype is currently equipped with two engines, an R Vac and a sea-level Raptor designed for atmospheric flight. The vehicle will be equipped with three R Vac engines and three sea-level engines for the upcoming orbital flight test. R Vac engines feature a much larger nozzle compared to standard engines. The increased diameter improves efficiency in outer space environment. During the static fire test, engineers fueled Starship SN20 with cryogenic methalox, a combination of liquid methane and oxygen. They briefly ignited R Vac for the first time as the 160-foot-tall vehicle remained grounded to the launch pad mount. Approximately half an hour after the test, SpaceX shared a stunning video of the vacuum Raptor's ignition. First firing of a Raptor vacuum engine integrated onto a Starship, the company announced on Thursday evening. SpaceX has only tested sea-level Raptors on previous Starship prototypes. SpaceX founder Elon Musk shared that the R Vac engine chamber pressure is currently at approximately 270 bars, but working on upgrades to get it over 300 bars, he wrote via Twitter. With one R Vac and one sea-level Raptor installed into the aft of Ship 20, the R Vac fired up after a notably smooth countdown, followed by an aborted attempt shortly afterward, which was then followed by both the R Vac and the sea-level Raptor firing up to conclude the evening's events. It is currently unknown what additional testing will be conducted on Ship 20, with the option to add engines ahead of static fire tests. Ship 20's complete engine configuration calls for three sea-level Raptors and three RVacs. The set, subject to swap-outs, involves RC-69, RC-73, and RC-78, with RC standing for Raptor Center. In addition, RV-4, RV-5, and RV-6 are the RVacs assigned to Ship 20. Aside from also marking the first time that two Raptor variants have been simultaneously fired on the same vehicle, Starship S20's two test surprise was technically the fastest back-to-back static fire SpaceX has ever completed, beating Starship SN9 by about 15 minutes. Back in January 2021, SN9 completed an unprecedented three back-to-back-to-back Raptor static fires in less than 100 minutes as part of what Musk described as a day about practicing Starship engine starts. SN9 ultimately completed two of those tests in 75 minutes, setting a niche but still impressive turnaround record. Starship S20, however, managed two static fires in 62 minutes on October 21. Booster 4 will also require its own ground testing campaign, with activity currently involving the aforementioned swap-outs of its Raptor engines. The Super Heavy will require proof testing ahead of an unspecified number of static fire tests, likely surpassing the current record of three Raptors firing simultaneously, and by some margin. With 29 engines lighting at launch, eventually evolving to 33, SpaceX will have options to fire up subsets of engines during initial testing, but will eventually fire all 29 at the same time, either before or on launch day itself. If Starbase works to Elon Musk's latest schedule, these tests will come in short order, following his claim of vehicle readiness for the test flight. If all goes well, Starship will be ready for its first orbital launch attempt next month, pending regulatory approval, Musk noted on Twitter on Friday. SpaceX plans to perform the first orbital Starship flight test, that will assess the performance of every Starship system and design, in order to develop the spacecraft. SpaceX is conducting pre-flight tests of each engine that Starship SN20 will fly with. Super Heavy Booster 4 will also undergo similar testing with its 29 sea-level Raptor engines. Once both vehicles pass all pre-flight milestones, the company will be able to conduct the orbital flight that will take the vehicle to outer space from the Starbase launch pad at Boca Chica Village, Texas. SpaceX will attempt to return SN20. It will cross Earth's rough atmosphere to land in the ocean off the coast of Kauai, Hawaii. The exact timeline for an orbital flight is still unknown, because the U.S. Federal Aviation Administration is conducting an environmental assessment of the Starbase launch site. The regulatory agency is in charge of ensuring safe air traffic and spaceflight operations. The FAA released a draft environmental review for the Starship development program, and invited the public to give their opinions on Starship activities in the South Texas region. The administration is accepting public comments via email until November 1st. Visit FAA official website for contact information. After their assessment concludes, SpaceX can obtain a flight license to launch Starship SN20 to orbit. However, Mechazilla's assembly and installation on the launch tower caught the attention of most regular Starship followers, as another of Elon Musk's fascinating ideas officially became part of the orbital launch system ground support equipment. This week saw the two chopstick arms pinned onto the carriage, ahead of the entire device being raised to the skate. Installation points on the tower Mechazilla, as named by Musk, will provide several services to the Starship program, starting with the ability to raise and stack the booster onto the launch mount, before then stacking Starship atop the booster. Along with the quick disconnect arm, it will also provide stability to the stack when on the mount. Eventually, and by far its star roll, Mechazilla will catch the booster and ship when they return to the launch site post-mission. This first attempt will not occur during the upcoming test flight, with both vehicles set to splashdown at the conclusion of their mission. However, Elon Musk did cite such a catch attempt could occur during Booster 5's return. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.